Hi guys, in this video we will have a look at the Stop Edit panel of Organteq 2. This is where you can design your console. This is also where you can voice individual stops and individual pipes. We will have a look at how it is designed and a few tips and tricks on how to use it. Let's go. Okay, so for this tutorial I will use the historical preset to Baroque Steinkirchen. So for the Stop Edit panel, you can access it with either the settings button and stop, or the shortcut S, or more convoluted, a right click on a doorknob and stop settings. The upper part of the window shows the current composition of the organ, that is, all the different stops organized by division, while the bottom half shows the detail and some information on the selected stop, so the highlight one, and let you tune all the associated parameters. We'll come to that later. Before, a short parenthesis. I am sure a lot of you guys are quite familiar with the organ lexicon, but I'd like to have a few words on what is an organ stop for the viewers who might be new to the organ universe. Basically, a stop is the basic sound unit of the organ. It is a set of pipes, one pipe per keyboard note, with timbral consistency along the tessitura or along the whole keyboard. We saw on the first video that there are two main stops, the flue pipes and the reed pipes in red, which can sound at different pitches, so this is related to the number of the stop. So, let's go back. In the upper panel, you have, for each organ stop, a small switch button on-off, which corresponds here to the main GUI doorknob. The switch slowly blinks here when it is played. When a stop is not activated manually, that is, with the 2T button or the crescendo, it is slightly ghost on the stop panel, and the ghost stops also slowly blinks when they are played. You can change your organ composition quite easily. With a single drag and drop, you can either paste a stop in a slot or move it, or swap it, or insert it between two stops. You can empty a stop with the delete key or with the little bin icon here. If you want to fill an empty slot with a stop, you just have to click on the Assign Stop button. It will open a drop-down menu of all the Organteq 2 factory stops sorted in two banks: French Romantic, German Baroque, and also sort by type, flue, mixtures, and reeds. Note that the character search is also implemented, so if, for instance, I want a Gedacht, here is it. Now the lower part. It shows all the parameters of the stop which is selected, so highlighted, in the upper composition panel. Okay, so now the lower part. It shows all the parameters of the highlighted stops. On the right, you have some informations: which period, German Baroque or French Romantic, which type, is it a flue, is it a reed, subtype, here it is a Gedacht, and the height, and a little introductory paragraph, and here an highlight of what the pipe of the stop look like. On the left, you have many sliders, which are the global stop parameters. They apply to all the pipes of the stops. Let's play a bit with just the Gedacht, for instance. I just want before to lower a bit the mechanical noises so we can focus really on the pipe sound. Okay, so we'll pass quite quickly on the volume. here you are the reverb mix, if you want, for instance, to have, for whatever reason, this particular stop to sound extremely dry or extremely wet. Now it gets interesting. You have the brightness parameter. It is a timbral modifier. It is not an after effect. It is not an EQ of some other filtering effect. It lets you play directly with some internal parameters of the physical model that have an impact on what is broadly called, well, the brightness. I will not disclose these internal parameters, but they have to do with the statics, so the geometry of the pipes, the mouth height for the flue pipe, and some physical characteristics of the reeds, and also some dynamic parameters on the wind and the jet. Playing with this slider lets you explore variations around the factory sound. Then you have the air noise, which is somehow related to the amount of turbulence in the system and how it is filtered by the pipe. It is actually a nice tool to give sensation of closeness to the organ chest, that is where the pipes are enclosed, or at the contrary, if you want to listen from quite far away. Then you'll have the chief slider. It lets you tune the amount of chiefs or little attacks transitories, so without chief and with a lot of chief. Note that there is no chief for the reed pipes. Then you'll have the wind jitter. It is the wind alimentation state, actually. Is the wind alimentation perfectly functional, so the steady sound is pristine and devoid of any jittering? That never happens in real life, actually. Or is the wind sag in extremely bad condition? That can happen, actually. You'll have then the detune in sense. And then the tremulant amount. So the boom icon here resets the stop to the preset parameters, while the factory icon resets the stop to the factory parameters, so that is with all the sliders in their default position. The two can be obviously different, and when one of these icons is highlighted in red, it means that one or more parameters of the stop currently differs from the preset here or the factory. As for the bin icon, a right click on one of these two buttons will reset all the stops to either their preset parameters or their factory default. Then you'll have the classical copy and paste buttons. Finally, you'll have at the bottom which tremulant, expression pedals, and maybe crescendo steps are assigned to the current stops. We'll go to these three devices and features in other videos, so let's skip quickly to the next and final part of this video, the pipe per pipe voicing. As previously said, these sliders affect all the pipes of one stop. One of the novelties of Organteq 2 is the possibility to fine-tune these parameters for every pipe of every stop. To access this feature, you just have to click on that button that will switch between the view pipe info and the pipe edit. You can also access it by a double click on a parameter to access its fine tune. You can choose here between some edit options, a simple draw, for instance, haircut, and octave. The mouse wheel is for tuning the note over which the mouse is hovering. Note that also if you play some notes on the keyboard, they are highlighted here. You can also create and move some control notes. You can then randomize, smooth, and rescale your fine tune. These buttons, they work with single click and also a click, hold, and drag. The small yellow arrow and the associated horizontal line represent the global slider value that you can also change from here. And I think it's done. We've been through all the features and functionalities of the stop edit panel. Okay, so that's it. We've been through all the stop edit panel of Organteq 2. On the next video, next week, we will have a look at the four different tremulants of Organteq 2 and at the three different expression pedals. We will have a look on how to use them and how to tweak them to your taste. Until then, well, once again, do not hesitate to have a look at our website, modartt.com, and to listen to some audio organ demos. Thanks for watching, and see you next week. Bye!